Pirates and Milwaukee for New Hampshire and Marquette. Here's Bob Brainerd and Brian Butch.
Dogs. Not to W. Nathan Fieldhouse. We're at five third form in Milwaukee, off and running. Marquette up with the first boost, and the activity underneath, Brian, special. And you got to look at this, because when you look at New Hampshire, they look smaller, but I'm telling you, they rebound at a different level. Ball swing, Lewis for three, long one. Gray's the front of the rim. Back the other way at the cat. Nick Johnson. Jaden Martinez, a couple of the experienced guys who have been on the court plenty. An American East Conference blood. Shot clock at eight. Blanco. Ball swing. Two to shoot. From the corner, three doesn't go for Nick Johnson, but a reset. Another three. This time it goes for Jaden Martinez.
We've talked about rebounding, but that's two back-to-back possessions there for New Hampshire. They get an offensive rebound. Creates more opportunities for them.
To the basket and the foul sent Perquet to the line. Shaka Smart. He's perfect, Brian Butch. 1-0, one against Edwardsville on Tuesday night here in Milwaukee. And college basketball fans know his story. VCU, then Texas, and now here in Milwaukee, he's a Wisconsin native, settling in, but nine newbies on this roster, five freshmen and four transfers to work with.
And the biggest thing with Shaka is culture. How do you get everyone to buy into what he's trying to sell? So far, he's been really good at that. Everyone's bought in. You can see the energy that Marquette has played with. That's got to be their staple.
Quinn, graduate, senior, 3 years at Oklahoma. Played the other night on Tuesday. Not his night, said Shaka Smart. 15 minutes, three blocks, though, and a couple boards. This is the freebies there. And the backcourt pressure applied by Marquette. In for the Wildcats. They will not crumble with the pressure. These guys know what's coming and they know how to handle it.
Now, the thing that you've got to watch is they're getting their offense started at 14. That's exactly what Marquette wants with this pressure. Getting their offense at 14. So far, though, New Hampshire's done a good job of being able to execute with 14 on the clock.
Perquet with the extension, the long reach, and the easy swat for him.
And you can't teach length. That's what a good shot blocker does. He wants space, he got space. That's how he's able to get the block.
Guadalama. No. Marquette on the push. Olivier Maxence Prosper. Another newbie. He goes by Omax. Orzel. Tyler Polak. Marcel, shifting, and buries it in the paint. 21 points, collegiate high for him on Tuesday. On the wing. Give and go to Martinez. Shot by the 10. Limit the possessions in this game. Use that shot clock. They do there with two to shoot. Jaden Martinez knocks it down for three.
That is great offense by New Hampshire. They took their time. They made the extra pass. Fantastic job.
Omax, the three. Side of the rim, no. And the Cats chase it down. Give it golf. Scoop won't go. For Johnson. Lewis, Axel. Marcel for three.
chance opportunities. Going right on the shoot about pace. You can see it. Marquette, go, go, go. And a foul there as New Hampshire winds the clock, deliberate and patient. That's what they want to do. That's what Marquette wants to do. What do we want you to do? Get this pace going a little bit. Create turnovers. Get some easy baskets. New Hampshire's done a good job in transition defense, making Marquette work for everything early on here in this game. Marcel gets the breather. Cam Jones in there, one of many freshmen. Along with 13, that's also Iguodaro. Got a good game off the bench for Travis Smart on Tuesday. Baseline drive. Trying to squeeze it in and a foul as Nick Johnson gets struck.
And you look at New Hampshire doing a great job of getting into the paint and then locating shooters where they're shooting or driving, right? Like, they have the option for both. But it all starts because they're able to get into the paint. When you get into the paint, that defense sucks in wide open than opportunities.
Johnson, American East Rookie of the Year a season ago. I'm going to watch Goliath Bilharian. 17th season, closing in on 200 victories. He's the all-time victories leader at New Hampshire. East Carolina, Drexel. Trying to get this Wildcat team to the first ever NCAA tournament.
You're going to see New Hampshire made the man. Did a great job of driving baseline. That was the biggest thing. You drive baseline, the help is a little late, and then it leads to a foul. Lewis, I love the way his growth. Everybody's talking about how much he's going to grow this year, right, Bob? That's a great example of an attack. We know he's going to improve from three, but that attack right there with those wide shoulders and big hip, that's how he's able to get to the free throw line, get some contact, and then try to finish it. I love that attack early on.
No main spot. No main spot.
First one good. Shaka Smart called Lewis an emotional guy who cares. Has that built-in fire in the belly. As you see, Josh Hopkins check in. This year's senior, former starter for the Wildcats. Lewis a double-double on Tuesday. His first ever in the college ranks, 17-11. Stevie Mitchell in. Tell you what, Brian, if you come to the Fiserv Forum, you need a Marquette roster because there's so many new faces in and out, in and out.
They are. Marquette on May free throws. Watch them go diamond press. That's exactly what they did. They did it in the last game as well. Good win. A great day if you're New Hampshire.
Way from Mitchell.
On the drive, the closeout, the top foot is too high. When you close out too high like that, you can easily get beat, put you in a bad position. That's why you get a foul.
Blondo with it. Working out Jones. Drives, overlays. Jones disrupted it. Colek pushes it. Corner three, the look. Mitchell, no.
Great offensive possession by Marquette. They were able to push it. They'll get wide open. Corner three, great shot. Just missed it.
And now New Hampshire setting up shot. Martinez. Cracked down. They're getting the look. They're not getting the finish, but Jones drives, lost the handle. Mitchell says, I'll take it. Stuck in the paint, gets out of there. Colek. No, but a foul. And Tyler to the line. This kid's a freshman, Brian, who plays like a savvy veteran.
It's a simple ball screen. We knew New Hampshire's going to go man-to-man. Just not enough help. Todd did a great job of turning that corner, getting enough contact to get to the free throw line. It's a great job of reading the screen.
Kolak transferred to Milwaukee from George Mason. He was the A-10 Rookie of the Year. Marcel returns for Marquette. Quan Murphy in for the Cats.
Get out, made free throws. Watch for Marquette to go diamond press here. They did it against SIUE. They did it the first made here against New Hampshire.
There's the make. Marion Ellis, another freshman. This is a recording. There will be bumps in the road. There will be baby steps that Marquette will have to take, especially in Big East play. But the upside of all these guys is through the roof. And Tanya Smart, it's his job to dig that upside out.
Nothing happens overnight. The biggest key for this Marquette team is, did they get better from game to game, day to day?
Murphy with five to shoot. Lost the handle. Rama puts it in.
But New Hampshire's bringing more energy than Marquette in this game. Right now, that's the storyline. They're all rebounding. 50-50 balls are all going New Hampshire's way.
Long three, Ellis. Air ball. New Hampshire basketball. Last possession. Watch
great
the tip.
Hustle.
The tippy toes, Brian. Ooh.
Sometimes you got to get lucky a little bit. But when you hustle, when you have energy, you get those calls. Not that it should have been the right thing. It was obviously a missed call. But when you do that, it usually benefits.
And by the way, basketball fans, your eyes do not deceive you. This is the ultimate Milwaukee Bucks court. Marquette's home court. It's in storage. It's damaged. A new one's on the way, hopefully by early December.
But Marquette is not getting bodies with their boxing out. They're not getting bodies. And then all of a sudden, offensive rebound leads to a three for slow. Who's a knockout shooter.
Seymour buries it on the second chance opportunity. It's the Cats by four. Lewis the backup. Twisting, turning, kicking. Mitchell took a peek. Still eight to shoot. Lewis will. Another rebound. Murphy. See the Cats, Brian. They get back quickly. Try to break that press. Then they go into it. They're in a hurry only to get into the front court. On the way up, deflected, last touch by the Golden Eagles. It's New Hampshire. Plus three here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
A shooter that's 6 points. That's a big difference there early on here for New Hampshire. How are we going to Marquette? 15-6.
We already touched on setting the tone on the road. Being more aggressive, having more jump in your step. That's been New Hampshire here. And got it back, but ran out of time. Shot clock violation, only kissed the glass. Bill Herrien orchestrated, as good head coaches do. Second chance opportunity for Marquette, thanks to Oso Iguodala.
Yeah, Iguodala does a great job of using his length. What did New Hampshire do on that end? They didn't put a body on Iguodala. And that's what happens. It's a simple game, rebound. You've got to get contact. You've got to make sure that you find a way to put bodies on bodies. If you do that, you're going to carve out space.
So you see all the new faces. We're in the Marquette doing goal. This is what the starters look like a season.
season ago. Garcia goes, Carton goes pro, Hewin, Kane, Theo John, they're all playing for somebody else. That's 50-plus points, Brian, that you're trying to replicate.
Shaka's got to replace 82% of the points, 79% of his rebounds, and 79% of his three-pointers.
Math is hard. And sometimes it stares you right in the face. But with it, opportunity for all these players. Underneath, tough move there by Johnson that came up shot.
And that's Ezekiel Udoka. His length is taking over.
But called for the charge. He got hung up in midair, and Nick Johnson took the abuse.
And what happens when you leave your feet? Bad things happen. Right? It's a situation there where a guy's there, he loses vision. It's the right call. The defense is set. New Hampshire, man-to-man team. When you're in that action, you know that there are going to probably be bodies there. One kick out. I like the aggressiveness. But have the eyes up. Don't leave your feet. And then try to find the shooters because they got sucked into the paint.
Golak is trying to shake the cobwebs. He's going to get a breather. You saw him wince a couple times and finally look over and say, Steal Mitchell, but blocked on the backside. Brought around. Goes from disaster to good fortune for the Wildcats. Hardcore press here by Marquette. And again, the veterans handle it. Seymour on and go. Back the other way, Marcel. Sidestep. Short. On the line.
Guadarrama has done a great job of walling up and chesting up the last two possessions. Easily steps out, but Guadarrama has done a great job. All you have to do is wall up in those possessions. He's done that. That's all you can ask for. Great job.
Is it old school, old rag? Does all the dirty work kind of guy. Locks it up, relishes it. Here he is with the basketball. Give it up. Drive, turn, too much. And they'll get Guadarrama there for the push, trying to carve out some space. He won another second chance opportunity. So we stay at 12-9.
Really good success with this action before. It's a simple chin action that's called. It's a high ball screen after a back cut. Really good action the first time. We'll see what they get on this possession.
On three, David Joplin.
They're going to come back with that chin action. They have had success in back-to-back possessions with that action.
Local kid, played at Brookfield Central High School. Shaka Smart recruit him to come to Texas. When Shaka came here, Joplin said, I'll stay here. First three for Marquette. They were 0-7 prior to Joplin knocking it down. David Joplin, his head, Brian, was on the swivel when Shaka decided to come to Milwaukee. And he's, okay, now what do I do? He talked to Shaka. He talked to friends and family. Decided to stay home and follow his coach. First miss by Johnson. Get out of the Bronx.
Force the drive. Lando is there. It's an easy charge. Right? that's just Dukes being young. That's all that is. Right? Drive, one dribble, you know the body's there, one kick, you can get it right back. But it's youth. And this is what Shaq has got to deal with, is how to get the young guys involved but not have turnovers. It's one of those where it's a learning experience.
It'll be on film tomorrow. We'll watch it. Now you saw Shaka right in the ear of Joplin. And he knocks, he knows. A dozen apiece. First half here in Milwaukee. Johnson. Whistle.
You can't reach with your hands. You've got to play defense with your body. Anytime you put it in the cookie jar, anytime you reach with that hand, you're giving them a reason to call the foul. Play with your chest, not your hands, no foul.
Bonus now, Johnson. This was an issue on Tuesday. It was foul fest, Edwardsville and Marquette.
Well, we know Marquette, right? They want to play violent. So,
yeah, there were 50 fouls. Whistle total in that Tuesday game. Edwardsville and Marquette. Marquette won 88-77. But it was just trip to the line after trip to the line.
And there were probably 49 legit fouls. There might have been one that wasn't, but there was at least 49 legit fouls.
I don't know who you are anymore. Former player? 49 of 50 were legit? Come on. Johnson again. Got them both. And you're already seeing Marquette out of Shaka Park mixing and matching. Foul called there. You're going to see a lateral. It's going to be like a revolving door at times, Brian, to get all these new bodies in.
Absolutely. And again, we talked about it on this end. We're going to talk about it now on this end. You can't reach with him.
Next foul. Marquette goes to the line. Cola to drive again. Prosper.
Open. Great drive by. He was able to drive, spin, great body control. Realized he was quicker than Guadarrama.
Clemson transfer. Get out of Montreal. Got it 14. Surrounded by yellow jerseys, he puts it in.
Martinez was really good down there. Very active.
Wildcats regain the lead. Olak with a give and go and an easy finish for Iguodala.
Olak with great vision there. Iguodala, great finish for him.
Causing a turnover. Using the length.
A little
Marquette.
A little spin.
Choquinyu. Now his coach says Choquinyu. The SID said what? I mean, we got three different versions here. And everybody said to us, just call him Blondo. And Blondo's good with us to say Blondo. Missed shot there on the field. Here is Blondo. Working on Mitchell. Guadarrama. Back jump. Watch the shoot. Josh Hopkins. Stuck inside. Guadarrama turns, fires. Doesn't get the rule. Mitchell the other way. Stevie will launch. That rims up. Rebound New Hampshire. This is what Bill Herrien said to us, Brian. He said, don't want to play slow. We want to limit possession, but they're going to do that on defense, not on offense. They'll set up quickly and then hit quickly in the corner with Hopkins.
Guadarrama with a great look across the court was able to find the corner three shooter. Really, really good look.
Prosper,
The answer, yes.
But, and that goes back to the way Marquette wants to play. They want to play with speed, and they want to play with pace. What's the difference? Speed is up and down. Pace is in the half court.
Father needs help. Finds Martinez. Adorama turns, works up Mitchell, gives it up. Body's there for Marquette. Rondo for three. Down. Back and forth we go. Personal from the outside now, heating up. Olaf. Not this time. Battle and last touch by Marquette.
You look at this. It's patience on offense. It's being able to understand and drive baseline. One kick, didn't have it, kick out to Blondo, wide open three. And that's a big shot for Blondo because he shot 33% last year. So his ability to shoot the ball better from three is huge for this New Hampshire team. Their big shot, great. Their guards, not so much. If their guards are able to shoot like that this year, watch out for Vermont. Watch out, everybody in the American East.
Preseason pick to finish third. They wound up in the most abbreviated version of basketball. By Martinez on the block. With the left hand, goes in. Martinez.
And what you're seeing is a lack of communication by Marquette. There's a cutter that comes across. Martinez comes right across, wide open.
Lewis brings out the three. Rondo on the paint. Olaf swatted it away. Crafty move. Marcel waits for help. Drives the foul.
And Quan's got to understand that Lewis probably doesn't want to shoot there, right? Now the drive's there, and this is what makes New Hampshire so good, is there's help, right? Even though Quan gets beat by Lewis on the drive, the help is there for the charge. This is what New Hampshire's built on, right? And that's why they've had so much success early on here. Hopkins is there to help a teammate. It's a charge. You can see Lewis getting a little frustrated, trying to find the rhythm of the game. And Marquette needs to play with better pace in the half court. Move the ball, get it side to side, find that pace. They're having a hard time finding that pace in the half court.
So far, the Golden Eagles got that 10-second call. But other than that, New Hampshire, they haven't sweated getting it over the front court. Need to shoot here. Martinez will. Ball follows around. Golden shirts are there. AAs that they're going to play in.
Absolutely. And the biggest thing here, when you look at how they're playing their way and their style. It's slowed down, they're rebounding the basketball, they're guarding. You can win like that, no matter where you go. And we're seeing that so far. It's a big 344 right now, though, for New Hampshire and Marquette. Can Marquette shrink this lead, get into half? Maybe with the lead, can New Hampshire build this lead?
Again. Hampshire patient again. Up and over the time. All around. Kicks off Poland. Dumps down wide open. Missed it though. Backside finish. Yes. It goes for Quan Murphy. Nick Johnson couldn't get the bunny. Murphy helped him up. Also, Marquette.
ball's in his hands a lot. With a little look off for the pass, Marquette extended their pressure. They picked it up, and they lost the guy behind. And Johnson, I believe that was. And all of a sudden, he misses it. But there's still guys there to pick it up. But Guadarrama is doing a great job. Only 2 points, no rebounds. But he's affecting this game with his playmaking ability.
Bill Herring says he's cerebral, which means he slows the game down. He understands the game. And when everything else is chaotic around him, number three, just you compartmentalize, right? You just say, okay, where does this have to go? What do I have to do? That's a savvy veteran.
But, and he gets to the free throw line because of a tic-tac foul. So, again, we talk about how this 333, now 250 is important in this game. New Hampshire, a couple of answers there.
Slap foul there on Martinez on this.
You talk about double advantage. There's a tic-tac that you don't want if you're New Hampshire. You're trying to build this lead. And you set Marquette to the free throw line. Martinez has been so good at this game. That's one he wishes he would have had back.
Aaron, you need to go out to get Martinez out.
And Prosper. Omax to the line. Place finish with Team Canada in the FIBA U19 World Cup. So while he's young, he's also played a lot of important basketball, Brian.
And you can see, you know, he's got the confidence. Now that's going to continue to grow. And I think that's the ability that he has and the growth that still is in his game is really exciting for Marquette fans.
Mitchell brings to Shaka Smart.
Yeah, Stevie Mitchell's coming in, and he's going to continue to grow all year long, but I love the ability to drive, realize that the defense has shifted, then the spin move, and then the finish. The only thing that adjusts on the finish is get your eyes on the glass. Eyes make lanes. I know it's a simple saying, but it goes a long way. But really, really good move. We might get either one, huh?
Lewis returns. Mitchell. New Hampshire in the final three and change have their good moments. Marquette having some moments here trying to close this gap before that time. There's another one. And they've got the time out. Somehow, Blondo in that mess was able to get the T.O. Brian.
And you can't dribble up the sideline in 5 minutes here. Again, Marquette's got to try to find that pace, get that energy. And the biggest thing is try to create some turnovers. They haven't done a lot of that.
Okay. There's your turnover. And here's your finish.
And that's when we talk about how to close a half, right? If you're Marquette, this is what you wanted. You wanted to find a way to close out a half. See if you can get the lead. Great response by this Marquette team.
Foul call there. But here's your energy out of the timeout for Marquette.
And it's an inbound that gets tapped away, and now you get to play with your speed. That's what Marquette wants to do. Get out. Put it home, big fella. That's what that creates. Turnovers create that.
Oh. sends Quan Murphy to the line. Transfer from Houston Baptist. You missed it. Joplin gets a transfer for the Golden Eagles.
And what we did talk about, though, now, is the foul Martinez got that put him on the bench has really hurt this New Hampshire team. Martinez being out the last couple of possessions.
Yeah, senior averaging 13 plus a game. Just a difference maker when he's in the floor. Lewis, look at that, with the left hand.
And that's a play during their shoot round that they ran. It said, we are going to get the ball on the elbow, and we're going to let you go to work, Mr. Lewis.
Marquette back in front. Murphy stops the start. Launched by Seymour. He gets fouled. Three coming. On the follow through.
In shoot round, everybody knows that Sloan is a shooter. So they're thinking, we got to get out, we got to get out, we got to get. We've been in this situation a whole bunch, but you've got to close out under control. That's the biggest thing. Sloan doesn't have a chance to land because of where Lewis comes out. It's so tough when that scout report reads, shooter, but you've got to do it with balance.
Something Shaka talked about post-game on Tuesday, the closeout of the three, being smart when you close up.
What's the goal of offense? The goal of offense is to create a closeout for both teams. If you do that, it gives yourself an advantage to try to attack that closeout. That's the overall goal. New Hampshire's done a good job of it at times. Marquette has done a good job of it at times. That's why we're sitting here, 28-29 ball game.
Which he does.
Even up with a minute to go.
Mitchell and Morsell way up top. Morsell will pop and hits.
And Marquette was thrown on the floor and wants to try to put him in high pick and rolls. You can see they're running five up to get that matchup. They got the matchup there. Did a great job.
Seymour again. Watching the right hand this time. Big time. Big boy rebound. Iguodaro. And Mitchell says, hold the court. We'll play for one. Barring anything you see Riverside S, Marquette will have the lead.
To get the switch.
Morsell.
For three.
And there's your energy and your lead going into the locker room at the half. Coming up after the break, Rod Stone.
He goes out because he gets a tic-tac foul on a rebound, and then all of a sudden Marquette takes advantage of it, and they've got that five-point lead because of that.
Martinez a year ago is the New Hampshire stat leader in health category. Provides so much, but his loss, his team penalty out there is definitely tough. With the basketball. The back down of the kick. Golden Eagles turn the table. Grab both.
right? But New Hampshire, they want to play that way. They want to slow it down, kind of see what happens. Gets into the paint, Love does, and he's able to go.
In the nick of time, if you will. He knocks down the three.
You look at Love, able to get into the paint. When you get into the paint, good things normally happen. All of a sudden, kick out for three. You look at that, there's only 3 seconds left on the shot clock. Way to execute if you're New Hampshire. Again, it slows the game down a little bit. Great answer.
Guadarrama now with six. That was an NBA three. And they've taped up the Bucks NBA line here, but you can see faint images of where that professional line is. As Marcel knocks down the first. Shaka Smart says, I'm hard on Daryl at times because he's so capable of doing so much, trying to extract what he can from this savvy veteran. We're kept by four. Round the horn we go.
Marquette switching it. That's why you're seeing their guards end up on the Panthers' bigs.
They force the long three. Rebound and push. And West. They can't reel it in.
And that's the speed Marquette wants to play. We talk about speed a lot. Well, the difference is that's a full court speed quickly, right? But that's just a tough pass for any big to catch.
Yeah, and Kweth is a big with a massive wingspan. Great press. Paint. Another three.
Bucket. Guadarrama. And Rondo gets to the paint again for a kickout three.
Different spot, but same result. New Hampshire within one.
Love the patience there by Cole. He's able to drive, realize that there's no help a whole lot on that, so he's able to come around and just flip it up for an easy basket.
He squeezed it in. Tyler now with seven. Talked about Nick Guadarrama, how cerebral he is.
You look at it, it's very simple, right? It's a pass fake to get going against the press. Then all of a sudden, Guadarrama's in the trail position. Love does a great job of getting to the paint. Like, it's just simple basketball.
That's the essence of cerebral, right? You're just kind of laying in the weeds and say, oh, by the way, I'm going to hit this three on you. Look at the double team. Patience, though, in the kick. Went off of Calgarian. Seventeenth year at New Hampshire. This is how you get your coach involved.
Well, Marquette wants deflections. They definitely got a deflection there.
Yeah, is that going to count? Does that count for two? We'll show you the deflection whiteboard that you tapped on right now. Nick Guadarrama cannot be stopped from outside.
With the shot clock running down on top of the foul.
He's got 12. A Marquette miss. New Hampshire tied at 38. Guadarrama now feeling it. Little give and go. Baseline drive and a foul. Chris Lester on the finish.
Guadarrama's taking over this game right now, but he is taking it over by his ability to see the floor, by his ability to shoot. He's so calm when pressure comes. A couple of times those should have been steals. They weren't. Then he's able to hit the passer, hit the cutter at Lester. He's just taking over right now.
Chris Lester, six-year senior. He's getting the start with Caleb Matos. Still out of action. Nursing an injury. New Hampshire has the lead. Stevie Mitchell knocks it down.
And sell to. Got it to the elbow, found a three.
Mitchell is running through him. He's getting touches, and he's got the vision to find the guys to have a better look than what he has.
And he's been great as the head of the press as well. He's inbounding the ball, and then he's able to see the whole floor.
New Hampshire all night has been very good against this Marquette press. With the basketball. Trailing by a single digit. Rolando. Penetrate and kick. Down, Jaden Martinez. His loss was felt, Brian, to close out the first half.
Absolutely, but where did Rondo get again? The paint, and when you get to the paint, you're able to get kickouts.
Seesaw, New Hampshire back in front. And a push foul there on Guadarrama. College hoops heating up here at Pfizer Forum. Just echo what we said at the outset. So good to be in this building and not be alone. People here, students here, the band's here. There's noise here.
The Marquette student section is always great. And this is what college basketball is about.
Cam Jones. Launch and connect.
Great set by Shaka out of the timeout to get the bucket. Now you see the energy on the defense start to pick up a little bit.
And there's the turnover. Lewis with the poke away. Mitchell puts it in and lost.
You can't ask for a better response out of a timeout than what you just got from Marquette. You run the play the right way. You execute it. You get a three. Then you get a turnover. It's just a simple steal there. Lewis gets his hands on it. Mitchell's able to finish through the contact. Marquette has had answers every time that New Hampshire had put together a run. Here's another answer by Marquette.
And the third foul. Whistle there on Guadarrama. How big would it be for Marquette to get number three off the floor?
But those are the fouls, like the energy, the violence that Coach Shaka's more wants to see. It's great, but that's the one you can't have. You're there, you're coming in, you're flying hard. And that's just from a young freshman. That's all that is. And there's learning opportunities to have with that. But that's what you can't have.
Now, Shaka wants controlled fire, right? If there is such a thing. And there is in the world of college basketball. Juan Murphy. Lewis in his face. Guadarrama with it. Morsell challenge. Poked away. Launch from the corner. Missed everything. We'll sell back quickly. Lob it. Too much for Kurth. Left again with a big reach. Finally out of his reach. Martinez. Poked away by Morsell. Dribble drop. Rondo in the paint. Kick. Martinez. Rimmed off. The freshman Jones.
He's come in and hits a big time shot. And that was great patience on that action. Really good there by Jones.
Recognition by Cam. He saw everyone back off and say, okay, freshman, let's see what you got. He showed him. Lando scoop comes up short. The push by Morsell. Lewis plays through the traffic and the contact.
And what is Lewis's strength? Getting to the basket. He didn't settle for a three, which he could have had. He aggressively attacked the basket, which was really, really good. Understanding wind, time, clock, all that stuff.
Carroll run by the Golden Eagles. Crowd response. there because Quan Murphy had nowhere to operate.
And as a big, when you're in this situation, you want to wall up, you want to chest. But if you look at the knee, it's down below. Kerr's able to get his knee into that offensive player there. And that's where Quan Murphy's able to take advantage of it. It's tough as a big. You got to wall up, you got to play with the chest after that. How about the response by Marquette? The 10-0 run, now it's obviously 10-1, but it started with the defense. They came out, they executed, got a three from Cam Jones, then got a steal. Mitchell's able to get a layup. Like, that's the energy Shaka needs all the time from his Marquette team. It's about consistency now.
And it came out of the timeout. Coaches draw things up, and it doesn't always go as planned. When it does, oh, big smiles over there. Lead is 6 from Arquette. Lewis thought about it. In the paint, strong. Second down. Empty trip. But the effort was there.
Speed is in the front court, is in the full court. We're able to attack. We're able to get those opportunities. Very, very good attack there by Morcell.
Foul on Murphy too late as he reached in.
And if you look at this, right, Lewis is attacking. Morcell is attacking. We know Marquette wants to shoot some more threes this year. But when it's time to attack, it's crunch time. When you need to find a way to get some easy baskets. Both of these guys, experienced guys, have known when it's time to attack. And that's why the lead is blue.
Marian Ellis in for Marquette. We'll give Mitchell a breather. David Joplin in as well.
That's just a one-on-one match. Guard your yard if you're Marquette.
Off guard that time for Joe. The proverbial straw that stirs the drink. Murphy. Quan Murphy from outside.
This is just a great college basketball,
isn't it?
I mean, you've got one response, you've got another answer. Like, this is just great college basketball.
And it's only game two. Bodies on the deck. Marquette keeps it. Shot clock at 10. And Marcel says no worries.
Give some credit to Aguadar because he got on the floor. He was the first one on that floor. The 50-50 ball goes to Marquette, and it Bango with the three.
Without it, turnover, New Hampshire basketball. Instead, they trail by 7. Murphy, 6 to shoot. Murphy off the bench. The senior. Showing some guts here from outside. Marcel, fade away, pretty. Senior savviness as well by the Maryland transfer. And there's a deflection.
That's another one.
basket, full of jump shots on the ball screens. He's done a really good job of being patient and not forcing anything. Only 9 field goal attempts. 6 of 9 from the floor. Like, really good job at just understanding when to attack.
Jack will want a lot of more fit. Yes, he's going to be the leader. Guys will look up to you. But they're also going to see when you worry about that last one. He's playing forward.
Martinez to the line.
And those are the fouls for the young players. Look at Els reach in. He did a great job. Forced the catch off of the block. Was able to continue to body, body, body. They let him play. They let him play. And then he tried to reach down. And as soon as he reached down, the whistle was blown.
Martinez, Bill Harriet, compliment here, Brian. His senior, a leaner, wiry version of Justin Lewis. Can you see that?
Pivot time, right? Like, you're able to see it now. I think the area that's not talkable, probably 3.2, right? As, you know, you look at this, Martinez shot 42% from three. If Justin Lewis shoots 42% from three this year, watch out! Watch out!
Shotgun and Marquette. Estelle the drive. David Joplin for three. No. Backside rebound, however, and a foul. Seymour on the reach. There was Oso Iguodaro, Brian. Right place, right time.
He's been fantastic this game. The box score doesn't show it, but Iguodaro has done a great job of keeping the basketball alive, giving Marquette second chance opportunities, diving to the floor. Finish. You drive, you show the ball, you get the big fella to jump up, and you finish. Great job on that.
Oh, and then Marcel can't find the handle. You see him clapping, though, saying to himself, next play, don't sweat it.
Again, this has just been a great college basketball game. There's been runs, there's been answers. Every single, we're sitting here at a four-point game, and it's because when Marquette makes a run, New Hampshire then answers. When New Hampshire makes a run, Marquette answers.
No one hanging their heads. No one running away and hiding. Good test for both squads. Almost a poke away. Guadalama back in there now. In foul trouble. Saddam. For a big jump.
They've been going to the post, right? Marquette's been switching this, so their guards have been on New Hampshire's bigs. And the toughest thing for guards, you're quicker. You can give a little space. You don't need to be right into them, right? You get into them, and that's why the foul becomes, and that's why Mitchell gets that tic-tac. Switch it there and take advantage of the height with a nice little fadeaway.
And here we are, 2-point game once again. Mitchell. Body's flying. That's Lewis. He hit the deck hard. New Hampshire gets the board. Guadalama. Look at the feed and the finish from her tie. The man who has in the back and the side and throughout his head. Look at this. When it looks like one team has the answer, the other team says, we can answer better.
And there was a timeout. Last time Marquette had a timeout, they ran a great set, got a great shot for a wide open three. Let's see what they run here.
They'll want to hand it off. Finds Lewis instead. Roster. Mitchell. Back to Morsell. Pull up top of 20. In there, active once again. Guess who? It's Iguodaro drawing the foul. How good has he been?
Again, you look at the stats, they're not going to show a whole lot, but they do show 9 rebounds, 4 offensive. That's a big, big foul on top of it. Now they're talking about it. This foul could be huge.
They're also going to send Oso to the line to shoot a pair. Say he was going up. Right here, Guadarrama undercuts.
So fouls on Guadarrama.
Yeah, that's four.
That's four there. And two shots.
Right. So double jeopardy for Bill Herrien. And the Wildcats, he said, hang on here. Are you sure you got the right guy? He doesn't want Guadarrama to be tacked with that fourth foul.
He's asked a couple of times, are you sure?
Right now, Guadarrama on the line. He's going to walk away and give way. Was it Guadarrama underneath with the push? With the officials, though.
And that's where they're first going to look, right? Because the contact happens there first. Yes, Quan Murphy got him up top on the hand, but it's always going to be down below first. That's what the officials' eyes are going to go to. It's the correct call.
Iguodaro splits the free throws. Marquette in front by one. New Hampshire. See how long they go here with 7 and change without a piece of their offense.
That right there is just, it's great to be aggressive, but Stephen Mitchell, being a young player, you don't want to reach in these situations. You're giving a reason to call the foul.
And that's four, number four.
And it's tough. It's tough. You want to play fast. You want to play with great pace. All of that. But you've got to be disciplined as far as when you're going to do. And it's a great teaching point by Sean. I love that.
Front end good by Lester.
That happens not all the time in college basketball, where a coach pulls a young player around and explains it to him.
Got them both. Brian, at what point does Bill Herrien bring Guadarrama back into this contest?
You've got to leave right now. You see how long it can last. We saw Martinez go out at the end of the first half and the lead from Marquette. You're monitoring that.
Lewis. In and out. Halfway down, and it popped up. Wild kept by one. Martinez. Isn't going to run through a kick now. You know that. Murphy in traffic. Tried to squeeze it in. He'll go to the line.
This is a tough play. You play with the chest. That's a tough one to go against Marquette. It is. You play, but as soon as the hips turn, it's the optics. Right? I thought it was a good play, but it's the optics of where the ref calls it. It's a 50-50 then at that point, and it goes New Hampshire's way. But who's been the team that's been more aggressive lately?
New Hampshire right now.
And they're getting calls. That's how this game works, Brian.
So simple, Brian. Hells gets by three. Big road double. Prosper. Can't prosper.
was good. Who couldn't have it? See the scoring run. See a lot of those tonight. Seesawing back and forth. The energy flows as the run fits.
Great attack by Marcel, understanding the flow of the game. And when you play longer,
if it's on Johnson, that's four. And that's why that was critical for New Hampshire. So it's Marcel trying to inch closer here with a deficit of three. And counting for Marcel, who had 21 on Tuesday night, his collegiate high. Never scored that much in his run at Maryland. And he might erase that tonight. The lead is one for the Wildcats.
His feet. He doesn't get him his foundation, right? You look at there, he's rolling out because of that, and it's that rollout that happens. He's gonna have his feet be steady, and then you don't roll out into a guy.
Third on Martinez. Marquette looking for the lead back. Marcel. Instead of work, 7 points in the first half for Marcel, 17 and 5 of 6 shooting here in the second half, and he feeds Lewis after the poke away for the free throw.
And we knew that foul for Guadarrama was going to hurt. And he said, when you put him back in, and New Hampshire's doing a great job, they didn't need to put him back in, but it went 3-2 foul, and it's going to be 6 points here that quickly turned.
Guadarrama back in. He was off the bench as soon as that foul sent us to a timeout with the basketball here. And 10-second call. Marcel was there to bother Nick just enough.
no words, right? My partner has no words. It's a first, ladies and gentlemen.
And the appreciation from the fans for what he brings. That's what Marquette basketball is built upon. Think about the great, that's what it's built on.
Michael Smart, Wisconsin native, born and raised here in Oregon. He's well aware about the history. It in. Place to try to do it, too. Drive cut off. Three ball Martinez. Needed it.
Great wiper action. They ran a pistol action, then they ran the wiper to bring the shooter Martinez back. Great set. Great execution by New Hampshire.
Another answer. After Marquette answer. That's been the theme tonight as Morsell draws the foul. To the line he goes.
You simply go ball straight here, handoff, then you wiper. The wiper is just a turnaround screen to get Martinez coming back. Guadarrama is able to set that wiper screen. That's just great action there by New Hampshire. When they needed the three, that's a great play to get a three. And then that's what an older team is able to do. They're able to execute that when it needs to happen.
With 24 and counting. He continues to pile up the points here in the second half. But not just the points, the energy, the aggressiveness defensively, the awareness. And yes, at times, this young Marquette squad, they will need that leadership where a guy says, look, guys, I've been in the trenches. I know what tight basketball games are all about. I will show you the way. Morsell has scored 9 in the last 10 Marquette points. They're up 4. New Hampshire won't go away, however. Londo, no, side of the glass. Rebound, Iguodala. Now it's Marquette to be got in a hurry, Brian. So with it.
Did a great job, played the spin, and because you reached out, it's gonna be a foul every time. I know Martinez is unhappy with this call. Marquette does a great job with twisting the ball screen. Now all of a sudden you're guarding the drive. Good job. Just don't reach down.
Whatever Justin Lewis does, in the world of Marquette fandom, it will never eclipse what he did last December 4th. A buzzer-beating tip-in on a missed free throw to beat the Wisconsin Badgers here in Milwaukee. Right now, the focus, though, is getting out of here with a W. New Hampshire still has life here with a 1:35 to go. Action underneath and foul underneath. And if that's on Stevie Mitchell, he'll have a seat.
Good action by New Hampshire.
Right, that's an easy bucket for Martinez underneath.
But that's where the ball pressure needed to be better on the passer. The ball pressure wasn't great, so Mitchell needed to come up and bump the cutter a little bit. But still, you can bump the cutter with your chest.
Front end good by Martinez.
And we're seeing this so much. Just the coaching, coming to the sideline, understanding how that's a bad foul. Marquette's coaches have done a great job explaining the teaching to these young freshmen.
They know the hand that's been dealt to them. 21 now for Martinez. 2-point basketball game. Morsell, who's been ginormous here in the second half. Off to Lewis.
pressure. Buckle your seatbelts, ladies and gentlemen. Perhaps a photo finish coming here in Milwaukee.
Really special.
It was showed off how special he could be at times under the former regime here at Marquette. And he wanted to stick around. Shaka Smart was named head coach. Lewis saw an opportunity to continue that role.
Marquette goes 2-3 out of that inbound. Pop it quick, Murphy, no.
Prosper cradles it like a baby.
Great call by Shaka to give a different look. New Hampshire doesn't need to foul right now. They can defend.
Both teams in the double bonus.
They're going to come with a high ball screen. They're going to twist the screen to change the angle, which they just did.
And Jones, the floater, rims it front. New Hampshire. Quick push now. 4-3.
Guadarrama keeps the Cats in it. Lack of communication and transition defense by Marquette. And Guadarrama's wide open in the trail spot. You're New Hampshire in this situation. You're going to want to try to trap a couple times. You're going to want to try to have Marquette move a little bit. But the shot clock's off. You're going to have to foul at some point. You're going to want to try to foul. Iguodaro, if he touches it.
All the way into the front court, and they foul Lewis.
And Lewis missed two earlier in the game as well. That's not a bad foul.
So the double bonus, two shots coming for Justin Lewis.
And great execution by New Hampshire. They almost had the trap. That was a tough pass. One that's a 50-50 one, right? Like a cross-course pass out of a trap. So New Hampshire did everything you wanted to do. Now you play this out.
3 of 6 at the stripe tonight. One rolls in for Lewis. Even with the make, New Hampshire has a chance for a triple that would tie it. Pure. Goes up, scoop, comes up short, and a quick foul. Tried to get the quick two, and Blondo went in the traffic and lost the bet.
And Justin Lewis did a great job of walling up. He just was with Martinez the three earlier. Just wind is coming down. It's tough to execute, and they didn't execute in that situation. Now, still got a rebound. Still got to give yourself a chance with 5.9 left.
Lewis may have iced it. Money at the line down the stretch.
Still forward in New Hampshire. You play it, obviously play it, the rebound, inbounds quick. Try to get a quick one here.
And the lead is 5 for Marquette.
And this is where Marquette's pressure makes it tough to get it. Catch it going downhill. Try to get a quick one.
There's the quick 3 by Martinez. Off the mark. And it goes final in Milwaukee. Shaka Smart is still perfect as the head coach of the Marquette Golden Eagles.
Great response by Marquette.